Hello friends, welcome to my ASRO study channel. Today we are going to discuss about our new chapter series, that is astronomy. So what is astronomy? Astronomy is a natural science that studies celestial objects and phenomena. It uses mathematics, physics and chemistry in order to explain their origin and evolution. Object of interest includes planets, moons, stars, nebula, galaxies and comets. Astronomy is the scientific study of celestial objects like stars, planets, comets, as I have said earlier, and phenomena that originate outside the Earth's atmosphere like cosmic background radiations. Okay. The night sky is the inspiration for astronomy, even though modern astronomy is carried out using large telescopes and electronic cameras. The beauty of the night sky is the reason most astronomers become hooked on their subject. Everyone can share this experience. Go far from any city or travel into a wilderness area. You will see thousands of stars scattered like a gems on a velvet backdrop. You will see the arch of the Milky Way. You will understand the awe that humans have felt for thousands of years when they contemplate the night sky. The unaided eye is good enough to see nearly 6,000 stars from a dark side, along with the planets and the brightest nebula. Take a good pair of binoculars and you will be able to see many nebula and star clusters. With a small telescope, you can resolve star clusters and see galaxies several million light years away. The Earth rotates eastwards, so the sky appears to rotate above us from east to west. Stars rise in the east and set in the west. All stars appear to rotate in concentric circles around a fixed point in the sky near the bright star Polaris. Stars' motions appear imperceptible from minute to minute, but over the course of an hour or so you can see new constellations rise in the east while others set in the west. Planets are bright objects that do not twinkle and change their positions among the stars from night to night. So friends, do you know that how can we locate any object on the sky? Let's find out. So we can locate any object on the sky with two angles. This is a direct analogy to the coordinate system of the Earth, where any place is specified by the two angles of latitudes and longitudes. One simple coordinate system in astronomy uses altitude and azimuth. The altitude of an object is its angular distance above the horizon, measured from 0 degree at the horizon to 90 degree overhead. Whereas the azimuth of an object is its angular distance around the horizon, which is measured towards the east from the north, that is from 0 degree to 360 degree. Astronomers most often locate objects in the sky with a pair of angles defined in the equatorial coordinate system. The equatorial system is tied to the Earth as a frame of reference. The angle of an object above or below the celestial equator is called the declination, which is measured in degrees, minutes of arcs and seconds of arcs. So friends, you know why east-west coordinates is more complicated? So let's find out. The east-west coordinate is more complicated because the Earth is rotating. Astronomers use right ascension measured in hours, minutes and seconds of times. The reference point for right ascension is the time when an object crossed the meridian, which is the north-south line that passed overhead. The zero for right ascension is defined as the position of the sun on the vernal equinox. The zero for right ascension is defined as the position of the sun on the vernal equinox, which is around March 1 each year. Right ascension increased towards the east because this is the direction in which the Earth turns. The range is 0 to 24 hours, and a particular right ascension might be expressed as 6 hours, 47 minutes, 56.4 seconds. Okay. So here we have an interesting data. For an object on the celestial equator, we can relate right ascension to angle as follow. The first one is 24 hours full rotation of the night sky is 360 degree. Okay. And 12 hours time between rising and setting of a star is about 180 degree. Okay. And the third one is 1 hour typical angle between constellation is equal to 15 degree. Remember that. And the next one is 4 minute time for stars to cross 2 moon diameters, which is about 1 degree. Okay. And 1 minute time for a star to cross half of moon diameter is about 1/4 degree. So friends, let's get to know that what is eclipse. The orbital motion of the Earth makes the sun appear to move eastward among the star. The path of the sun in the sky is called eclipse. Each day, the sun moves about 1 degree eastward along the eclipse. Each night at a particular time, the constellations are seen about 1 degree farther to the west. In other words, stars rise or set 4 minutes earlier each night. On March 21, the sun is at right ascension of 0 hours and star at right ascension of 12 hours are overhead at midnight. On September 21, the sun is at right ascension of 12 hours and stars at a right ascension of 0 hours are overhead at midnight. In this way, you can see different set of constellations as the Earth sweeps around in its orbit of the sun. Okay. So friends, the ecliptic is the path followed by the sun, so it defines the plane of the Earth's sun orbit. Since the solar system is nearly in a plane, all the planet can be found within a few degree of the eclipse. Okay. Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter and Saturn are visible by eye, whereas Uranus and Neptune are visible through binoculars. You need a small telescope to see Pluto. The celestial equator and the ecliptic intersect with an angle of 23.5 degrees between them, because that is the tilt of the Earth axis as it orbits the sun. The planet move among the stars from night to night. Mercury and Venus are interior to the Earth's orbit, so they never appear far from the sun. The outer planet may be found anywhere along the eclipse. The constellations along the ecliptic include the 12 signs of the zodiac. Okay, these have always been the most famous of the 88 constellations in the modern sky.